So I want to add some more to video number two. Now, for the last year or two, the last couple years, especially the last year, I've been contemplating taking myself off the internet. And electricity. So this isn't something new. This is just the first time I've shared it on the public record, on the YouTube public record. So if you haven't, if you've been watching these videos and if you haven't got the hint that that's where I've been leading to, then you know now. So I have been purposely planning this for the past couple of years. Just haven't said anything about it. So I never used to be on the computer till the year 2007. I never knew nothing about computers. The only reason I got involved with the computers is because I decided to spend money to get a grant coach to open my own guitar business, a guitar store. And after I paid an enormous sum of money to the company, and my teacher contacted me, he said the first thing I need is a computer. So I went ahead and bought a computer. And that introduced me to the world of computer and internet, and then YouTube and Stick'em. Everything's been all right, though. I've learned a lot about the Earth, the world, the universe, everything. But it's come now to a time where I need to go back to living without it. And who knows how long that's going to be. Or maybe I just need time away to find some equilibrium. But within the next month, 2 months, 3 months, it all depends. But who knows what's going to happen. Maybe I'll stay on. We don't know. We'll know once it's happening. We'll see. Now, I did take a one-year hiatus from YouTube during the year 2012, and the only reason I did was because I had two copyright strikes against my YouTube account. So I quit making videos on YouTube out of fear of getting another copyright strike and them knocking all my YouTube videos off. Getting rid of my channel. They do that. So I put all my videos on private except for just a few music videos and locked everything down. And after the year was up, all of a sudden I got a surprise and the YouTube strikes were taken off. And later on I found out that that's what they do. They wait a year, and if you're good for a year, they put you back in good standing. That was the only reason I took that 1 year hiatus, and it was nice. But I spent all my time on Stick'em though. I went into the Stick'em rooms and just had a fucking blast, man. I fucking wore shit out of myself, but I went in there. It was just like going to clubs, playing in clubs every night. I was playing in the YouTube clubs, man. I had my club that I went to all the time, and I played my music live in the club, man. And whoever wanted to listen to me was there. And the owner of the room allowed me to be in there and do whatever the fuck I wanted. He didn't care, man. So, although some of his moderators kicked me out here and there, for a night or two or whatever, but I always went back on, and he never kicked me out, though. He liked me. He was always making comments about me in the chat. Oh, they're just play, man. He's doing this and he's doing that. Shit like that. But then that Stick'Em went down, and that's shortly after that, then my YouTube account went back into good standing, so I went back to YouTube for a while. But Stick'Em ain't around no more, and there's nothing like Stick'Em. There's Tiny Chat, but it doesn't have the room controls and the sound controls that allows us just to do whatever the fuck we want. And if someone doesn't want to hear you, they can just undo your mic. And the Tiny Chats, they don't have a spot where you can just put your mic on and leave it on it all the time. And the way Tiny Chat is built now, if you want to talk, you have to press the button and talk, or else leave yourself on and talk. But when you're talking, the whole room has to hear you, unless they manually punch you out somehow. But it's all explanation of the details how it works, but you know, that's how it is. But it was good that Stick'Em stopped anyway, because I was wearing myself out too much, man. I was doing fucking music shows fucking every night, fucking preaching on The Sin and Illuminati, Fourth Bad Jesus, everything, man. I was a mouth, man, just running my mouth like a motherfucker. But I was having a good time. And I found a lot of my personality that I needed to work on and improve in. And I did a lot of those things. I improved a lot. So within the next month, 2-3 months, you know, I didn't pay my internet bill this month. So usually what they do is they go 1 month, and the next month they say, well, you owe for 2 months. Then after that, then they probably end up dropping you at the end of that second month. So same thing with electricity. I'm on Catholic Community Services credit, and they give us $300 of credit a year, but I only use very little of that, and I can make it last for like 2 years. But the power company said, well, you owe us money for this, and that. For the water bill, because I quit paying the water bill too. And it's like $400 for the water bill. And so they said, well, since I US that money, we're going to take some of your electricity credits and put it on deposit. Like $250 deposit. So it dwindled down my electricity credits. They've done that twice now. I've had $600. Electric credit the past 2 years. They took 250 of last year and 250 of this year. So I only got like $30 left. And then my electric bill is about $25 a month. So it'll be probably 1, 2, 3, 4 months. It all depends on how they want to play it out and cut it off. But I could enforce my lien position if I want right now, and I can make them keep the power on, no problem. All I gotta do is send them a more clear affidavit to the lien that I already have in place in the public record. Get them to agree to everything I want them to agree that's more clear, then take them and put them as debtors on my UCC-1 and put all those pipes and electricity meters as my property on the UCC-1 financing statement. And at that point, they will say, and lean them up for $2 million a pop or more, and add them to the true bill I got them sent to the county court and the bankers. So it's all just, I'm just waiting, taking my sweet time. That's one thing that I have no problem being in haste in, and that is the commercial lien process. I just like to sit back because I like to see what they're going to do, and I learn little step. Each time I take a step, I see what they do, and I say, okay. So this way I can also share that information with other people. So, So we'll see. We'll see what's going to happen. So either way, I'm going to be happy. And even more happy as soon as I take a hiatus from this electricity and internet. All right. Till the next video. Peace be with you.